Hardly anyone who would dispute the importance of analytics in today's world. Any large organization, any Fortune 500 firm realizes the promise which analytics holds. Some organizations are able to harness that power of analytics. Some organizations are not able to harness that power of analytics. With the amount of data that is available, with the advent in technology, with the computing powers that are available, and overall our ability and intelligence to handle all of this data and get insights out of it and make data-driven decisions has just grown multifolds. But then why is it so that some organizations are not able to harness this particular promise from analytics? One of our hypotheses is that when you do not have C-suite involved, when you do not have senior management backing, it becomes extremely difficult to have the impact that you're looking to make with the use of analytics in the organization. How do you go about making that impact and how do you get your C-suite involved is something that I wanted to talk about a little bit. I want to quote Hans Hofmann, who was a German-born American abstract artist. He said, "Our ability to simplify is to eliminate the unnecessary so that the necessary can speak." What he essentially was trying to say was that things should not be complex to be understood. And at Fractal, for a long time, we have been talking about complexity in creation and simplicity in consumption. I think one of the divides which we have between business leaders and analytics leaders, or other way to look at it is senior management and people who are doing analytics, is just the way analytics is being designed and executed in the organization. A lot of analytics right now grew operationally. It was bottoms up. It was functional, it was siloed, and it was disjointed. And as it bubbles up, it stays that way. It becomes very complex. And at a senior level, if you're looking at, you know, thousands of reports, if you're looking at, you know, innumerable KPIs and you're trying to measure your business, then it becomes very difficult to make sense of it. So how do you simplify that? So I think one of the things that we as analytics professionals need to do is simplify and understand how we can make analytics top-driven and have actually power metrics or certain KPIs which can be trickled down for the rest of the business rather than keeping analytics siloed and operational the way it currently is. The other interesting thing about analytics is that we need to focus on creating the right value. If you want C-suite attention and engagement, then if we get stuck at the L of P&L, then we will never be successful. So analytics needs to talk about monetization of data. There are enough data assets in any organization which can be married to external data sets, which can be harnessed in very many ways. So I think there is a lot which needs to be done from the point of view of talking about return on investment, articulating that very well, monetization of data, and actually taking a much longer term view rather than a short term view of the analytics that we are doing in the organization. That would for sure attract the attention of the C-suite, which is looking at creating more value for the business. It's not just about keeping the lights on, but it is about how do I create more opportunities which actually add value at the top line of the revenue for the organization. We've said that half-life of knowledge in analytics is 3 years. With the amount of changes which are currently happening, the amount of AI, machine learning, and technology overall which is being thrown into analytics, I think the gaps in capabilities and skills is only going to increase in future if we do not take care of it. I read a recent HBR article which said by 2025, Fortune 500 company would have an AI machine sitting on the board. It would process all the data and it would have all the answers and it would be there so that it can actually vote on the board. So it would have a voice of its own. That's a very interesting proposition, but what that also tells us is that other people who are there in C-suite, business leaders, need to learn a lot more about analytics. The analytics leaders need to speak a different language. They need to ask the right questions. Asking the right question is more important than giving the right answer. And I think by understanding, you know, how much data is available, what to look at, what to not look at, and what is the right question, we can change the conversation which happens between C-suite and the analytics leaders. I think that would bring about a huge amount of change if we are able to achieve that. For analytics to be transformational, for it to be strategic, for us to be able to institutionalize analytics, it has to bring about a cultural change in the organization, which requires it to be more outward focused rather than inward focused, which it is right now. It needs to think about how do I talk to certain people. It needs to think about relationships. It needs to think about softer aspects of implementing huge amount of change in the organization. If we are talking about AI machines sitting on the board of companies, it would require significant amount of cultural change which needs to be brought about, for which the analytical processes, the governance, and the leaders who are executing that change need to start thinking differently. They need to be more outward focus rather than inward focus and develop capabilities which would make them effective in those challenging situations. The rate at which disruption is coming, I would go one step further and say that it is not enough to just engage C-suite in analytics, but actually we have to onboard them, we have to connect the dots, and we have to prepare them for tomorrow's future.